हेलो। तो हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ सत्येंद्र, आई एम फ्रॉम मध्य प्रदेश भोपाल सिटी। माई क्वालिफिकेशन इज मास्टर डिग्री इन फिजिक्स एंड मास्टर डिग्री इन मैनेजमेंट। सो आई हैव ड्यूअल मास्टर डिग्री, वन इज इन फिजिक्स एंड अदर इज इन मैनेजमेंट। I am having 21 years of experience in teaching, training, and in industries. So this is my short and brief introduction to you. Today I am going to share with you, teach with to all you about the laws followed by a matter of substance, whether is it in state of motion or it is in a state of rest. First of all, the great physicist Sir Isaac Newton of England, in his time 1600 BC, invented these principles known as the law of motion in physics. So, as you see on this slide uploaded to the screen, the first law tells that any object at rest will remain at rest and any object in motion will remain in motion until and unless an external force acted upon it. So, in case of absence of any force, the state of rest or the state of motion will be continued by that matter or by that material. This is the first law. It is also called the law of inertia, because as you know, inertia is an internal property of a substance to resist changes in its present state of motion or rest. So this is the normal tendency to oppose any change in its present state, with either is in rest or is in motion. So it is called inertia of that body. So it is also termed as Newton's first law of motion or Newton's law of inertia. So the first law of Newton tells that if the force is zero, then body will be in rest or the body will be in motion, whatever the case may be, until and unless an external force, an external unbalanced force acted upon it. That's all. So, to make it more clear, to make it more understanding among us, I have just shared a picture of example in this slide, which you may see here. That we wear seat belt, safety seat belts while we're driving a car, a four-wheeler, just because to keep our safety in case when we suddenly stop the car by taking emergency brake or by any other means. Because in this case, what happens if the car comes in rest by use of the brake, but the body is not coming in rest instantly? So it comes to forward direction and go outside of the car. So this is the first example and the first second example which I want to share with you. And the second law of motion and the second law of motion, Newton's second law of motion, tells that if a force is acting on a body and produces an acceleration, then the acceleration produced is directly proportional to the magnitude of the force and inversely proportional to the mass of the body. In mathematical terms, it is expressed as F is equal to M into A, where F stands for mass, M stands for mass, F stands for force, and A is for produced acceleration due to the force F. So, to make it more clear, see the example. When a man tries to push a car, then the force to push the car is required to be more because the mass of the car is more high, that is 1000 kg. So, the acceleration produced will be less just because mass, when mass will be greater, then the acceleration will be lesser. When the mass will be lesser, then produced acceleration will be more. So in this case, the acceleration produced is less, just 0.05 meter per second square. So this is the Newton's second law, which is a relation between force, mass and acceleration of a body. Now I am coming to the third law of motion. The third law of motion tells that every action has similar and opposite reaction. Means when a bird flying in the sky, a rocket flying in the sky is an example of this third law. Why? A bird pushes the air through its wings downward and the air pushes the bird towards upward in opposite direction but with the same magnitude. That's why the bird is able to fly in the sky. Similarly, the rocket science is also based upon this principle. The fuel pushes the ground downwardly and the ground pushes the rocket upwardly, so rocket flies in the sky. This is the third law of Newton. So in total, all these three laws invented by Sir Isaac Newton, a great physicist of England of 1600 BC, invented that a force acting on a body is zero, then body remains its state of motion or rest. That is the first law. The force F, when produced acceleration A of mass M in a body is directly proportional to the magnitude of force and inversely proportional to the mass of the object. So this is the Newton's second law, which tells that the acceleration produced is directly proportional to the magnitude of force and inversely proportional to the mass of the object. And the third law is every action has similar and opposite reaction. This is third law. So today I am sharing this Newton's law to all of you to know about it to have some concept clarity about it, and in future I am going to be in more detail, in more specific way to teach all of you about these topics and another topics. Till then, good night, have a good day, bye.